This is the Vernier soil moisture sensor. It's used to measure moisture content in soil. So you might use it in an agricultural setting. That's, you know, soil moisture would be important. And so you could actually monitor the soil under a plant, see what happens there. You might use it in bottle biology. So you've got a one of your columns and you want to monitor that soil moisture content. So that's what you use it for. How it works, it actually measures the capacitance of the soil. And what happens is that the moisture content of the soil changes the capacitance. And so it's actually measuring the dielectric permittivity of the soil, and it's proportional to how much moisture there is. And so by changing the moisture in the section of the probe, you're changing what the reading is. Now, the reading on the sensor is actually reading in the volumetric water content of the soil. And it reads 0 to 45%. Now, this causes issues sometimes. People are like, well, why in the world would a soil that is really wet, why does it read 45%? Well, the thing is, you have to think about what is soil. Soil is made up by, you've got minerals, you've got some organic content, and there's also spaces. And so you've got pore spaces in there. It's not a solid piece. And what happens is that as you add moisture to the soil, you're filling up those pore spaces. And you can't have the soil be 100% water. It's just not possible. And so that's why it reads in that realm. So it's a common unit that would be used in measuring soil moisture content. So to use the sensor, we need to place it into the soil. And we use it by putting it in horizontally. The natural inclination might be just to take it and just jam it into the soil. You don't want to do that. You want to have it go in sideways this way, because that way you get a better reading, and because you're using a slice of the soil down below there, and it needs to go in that way. So let's go outside and I'll show you a real world case of how you would use this in the environment. I'd like to show you a common use case with this and how you would place it in the ground out in the field. And so what I've done is I have a sharp spade here with a trenching shovel. And this will allow me to put a little groove in the ground where I can put the soil moisture sensor down into that groove. And so there's some technique to this, and so it's important to know how to be able to do this. So to start with, what I'm going to do is basically open up a trench in the ground here. So I'm just going to press down a little bit there, open this up just a little bit, just wide enough that I can get the soil moisture sensor down in there on its side. And then I will take the soil moisture sensor and I place it down into the hole gently on its side there. And then what I need to do is firm the soil up around the sensor to the same compaction as the soil around it. So that may take a little bit to be able to compact it back around there. So I just press down gently, pack it back in there. And now I have my reading. Another thing to be careful with the soil moisture sensor is removal of the sensor from the ground. The natural inclination would be to just grab the wire and yank it out. You want to be careful because if you've packed it down nicely, it could be in there fairly tightly. So you may need to dig it out a little bit to be able to get to it so that you can ease it out of the ground here without yanking the wires. So we've seen how to place the soil moisture sensor out in the field. But what I've done here is I have a little plastic bin here and I've put some soil in here, and it's loose soil from the garden. And so I'm gonna use it just to be able to make some measurements inside here. So I'm just gonna put it down here. And I need to place the sensor into this soil, much like I did out in the field. Now, this is very loose soil, so it's going to go into a trench, but because it's loose enough, I can actually dig a slightly trench here and place it in there sideways, because it's loose enough that I can actually do this. And so I'm going to place it down in there like that, and then I will put the soil around it, and then like we said out there, it needs to be packed down to about the same compaction as the soil around it to be able to do the measurement. Now that I have the sensor in the soil, I'm going to plug it into the LabQuest. And now I end up with a reading of getting 9.3% there, thereabouts. So that's my soil is fairly dry on some garden soil that I had. And so that I could just read a meter and be able to go around and measure different values of soil at different places. Often, like in this case, you might be interested in just individual reading. So you might just read it off the meter itself at this point. You could set it up maybe with a selected events mode where you would measure the soil moisture content maybe in different areas if you wanted to. You can do it over time if you wanted to. So this is where you might go in and set it up for a long period of time. Why don't I at least show you how you might do that one, just set it up. We probably won't actually do a run on this one, but we might set it up. So I'll show you how you do that. Take a look at what the default collection parameters are, though. So for this one, it's a time-based one sample per second for 90 seconds. I might want to change that. So, you know, one use case might be to monitor the soil moisture content over a period of time. And so let's suppose I wanted to measure a sample for 24 hours. And so if I wanted to do that, I can go up and change that by tapping on the collection parameters there. Time-based, leave that the same. Let me do this. So change my duration, and I want to do, say, 24 hours. And then maybe I want to do, I don't know, four samples an hour, once every 15 minutes, and so I can say done, and then I hit OK. And well, what happened now is if I hit collect, it would collect data for 24 hours, once every 15 minutes. And I might have a situation where I have a heat lamp or something on my soil sample, so I'm drying it out and could measure that effect over a period of time. So let's remove this again from the soil here, and we need to be careful. You don't want these students just to yank this out. We talked about that outside, but so we can kind of dig it out here, pull it out here, kind of brush it off, and now we're good to go there. So again, the soil moisture sensor, it would be very useful in agricultural setting, horticulture, biology. And this could be really nice in a situation where students want to do some kind of inquiry activity, where they are monitoring the growth of a plant and in using it to adjust the soil moisture content and be able to do that. So, you know, inquiry is a big thing that is happening now, and so this would be a great sensor for those kinds of activities.